And Terry, I want to show you something right now. There's been a chain link fence that's put up around the entire parking structure, and a scaffolding is being built even at this late hour here, right where that slab fell off yesterday evening. And the sheriff's deputy still guarding the area here to keep the public out as that scaffolding is being built for this investigation, where investigators saying they'll take their time to make sure they get it right in finding a cause of the tragedy. Sources, though, tell us the investigation is focusing on the original installation of the panel nearly 20 years ago.
Sources tell 12 News that even as emergency crews were working at the scene on the death of 15-year-old Jared Kellner, it was apparent from a look at the fallen panel that raised questions about how it was installed. Our sources indicate the panels were supposed to be attached to 4-inch-long stainless steel pins, hung almost like a picture frame, then attached with bolts. We've been told there doesn't appear to be a structural problem with the concrete panel itself, rather its attachment. And investigators appear to be focusing on what looked to be several areas of where the concrete wall gave out, taking whatever supports would be there with it. Milwaukee civil attorney Robert Havish's firm has investigated numerous fatal structural incidents, including the collapse of the Big Blue Crane at Miller Park and the explosion at Falk Corporation. He tells us the focus will be on the materials and how they were assembled.
Well, you'd have to have it tested. I mean, there are structural engineers and there are testing laboratories that can look at the concrete and see if it was, when it was installed, was of insufficient strength. The bolts that attached the that decorative piece to the garage structure could have been metallurgically defective.
And as teams of engineers spend the next days and perhaps weeks making those determinations, Havish says it's clear this should never have happened.
Determine whether it was defective material or whether it was defective attachment. It wasn't an act of God. This happened through human error, whatever it may be.
And again, this is a live picture of a crew building a scaffolding here as part of that investigation into why that slab detached from the building. The sheriff's department is the lead investigating agency in this investigation, but the district attorney's office is also working on it. And they're not giving us any timeline yet on how long that investigation may take or how long it'll be before this garage reopens. Reporting live at the O'Donnell Park Garage, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.